This conference will now be recorded.
So these are the different documentations from an EC payroll point of view, and I have updated as per the latest release. So you know, the latest release is just 2 days back. This 5th of June 2020, the recent release for EC payroll has been published. That is, we call it 1H 2020. Okay, so why we are calling 1H? Because previously we had a scenario of Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4. Yearly, four times we used to have updates. But from this year onwards, we'll be having yearly twice. This is the two updates we'll be having, one around in the month of June and another around month of, say, November or December. Okay. So for that reason, you'll be finding a lot of documentation has been updated. So these are the series of documentations. Anyway, I have already updated in the all-in-one guide, which I have shared with you yesterday. But when it comes to the, you can directly in the upcoming quarter or upcoming months, you can always refer this URL. That is a master URL for your Employee Central payroll, where exactly you can download all the implementation guide anyway. Suppose if you want a single implementation guide, okay. So whenever in the all the implementation guides, whatever you'll be seeing in EC payroll, they are categorized into different parts, okay. The first part is a discover part. So in the discover part, you'll be finding four documentations. Okay, one is regarding your what is the EC in EC payroll scope. Okay, so that is the first documentation. And what is doable and what is not doable in when it comes to EC payroll. So it gives an overview of what is possible in EC payroll at present and what is not possible in EC payroll at present. So those things are there in the that you must read before you go for any kind of implementation project. Second one, the document which you will be getting, that is your, it's good to know, but ideally it is relevant for your most of the project managers or project coordinator who will be going through this document. They will be seeing it's a kind of RACI matrix, like who is responsible, who is accountable, who should be consulted, or who should be informed. Those kind of information should be there. Like I'll be giving one example here from the real-time projects. So suppose you have acquired the licenses from EC payroll. Okay. Once you have acquired the licenses, your as a client in IT infrastructure team or as an SAP basis team, their responsibility lies in they have to do the initial basic setup configuration, or there are some VPN connection to be established. There are some connection to be established between the SAP and client server. Okay. But because those things we do not do as a functional consultant, to be frank, those infrastructure related activities, that is the responsibility of your client IT team. Client IT team, as well as your SAP basis team from your organization as an implementation partner, both of them will be responsible. So this document will be talking about who, what are the activities and what are the activities, who will be doing what. Okay, so that is just an overview. Like, so you can modify it as well, but there are certain activities, like some, if it is some cloud infrastructure team, so there are certain activities to be done by SAP. SAP will be sharing with you those credentials, those URLs for EC payroll and all. Okay. So that document will be helpful for you regarding that. So this is the second document. Third one and fourth one, it is regarding a VPN connections. Okay. So why we require a VPN connections? Okay. So SAP EC payroll runs on a web-based GUI. Okay. Suppose if you do not want to use web-based GUI, rather you would like to use your SAP standard GUI. Okay. So for that, to access to your SAP standard GUI, you have to connect via VPN. Okay. So you can't have a connection directly established between for a security purpose. You require a VPN connection. Your client must have a VPN connection, and that establish how to establish that VPN connection to your EC payroll. That is actually your SAP basis team will be doing, but how to do that, it is good to know, but I will not force you to study this, because that is a more of an SAP basis activity. So how to establish this connection, infrastructure and all. Okay, so that's a good to know. Similarly, the fourth one is the fourth document is for also for the same purpose. You have to use SAP router connection for those kind of VPN and all. But if you're using Microsoft Azure, so there is a cloud offering from Microsoft Azure, especially for Canada and US, instead of having SAP data center, they store all these things in the Microsoft Azure cloud. Okay. So this is good to know, but I will not recommend to, it's not also relevant for your certifications and all. Your SAP basis team and your IT infrastructure, client IT infrastructure team, they will be doing this setup. Okay. So for that reason, I categorized these documents under your discover stage. Okay. So your client will be discovering everything, and your SAP IT team, and you'll be just to make sure that these things are done. Okay. So before you start any kind of further step, okay. So this scope document, service catalog document, your VPN connection must be established. Okay. So these are the four things actually in the discover page we generally go through, and the specific documentation from that. It is good to know all of these things, but not very important for from a functional consultant point of view. Okay, it is good to know. Next one is this, what is new? So any idea, what is the you any idea regarding this, Navdeep? What is new? Here is a recent update has been come in this release. There's something called what is new viewer. Any idea? What is a new viewer?
Nope.
Okay. So it is not what is new. There is something called concept of what is new viewer. It is not only applicable for EC payroll across SuccessFactor any product we call it, like whether it is Employee Central or whether it is an RCM, onboarding, LMS, any module you call it. SAP, whatever the, it is just a release management strategy of SAP. So suppose we are having in 1S 2020. This is the first half of 2020. What are the new releases? What are the new updates has came up in this first half of 2020, there is a dedicated website for that. Okay, so under help.sap.com, so you'll be finding something called SAP what is new viewer, and in that, if you go and filter, say I'm interested being a payroll consultant, I'm interested what is new in my Employee Central payroll and payroll control center, I'll just tick that filter and I'll be getting those what are the new updates in this quarter or in this first half of 2020. So you'll be getting a list of these things, like you can also download it. Okay, so these are the different new things you can see for EC payroll. It came up in this just 2 days back. Okay, so like it was released on 5th of June 2020, and these are my different new features that came up. Okay, and in this you can also see whether it is a localization or it is a suite integration, that you can find it in the feature group. Okay, so in the feature group, if I go, if it is related to suite integration or it is a payroll control center, that is an universal in nature. Or if it is localization, only thing is it is applicable for a specific country. So you can see there are certain configuration or certain new changes, new updates have came up from specific countries, say Australia, and there are certain changes came for China. Okay, so for this, you do not have to implement everything. Suppose if you have implemented EC payroll for China and Australia, then you have to go for. Otherwise, this localization you can ignore. Okay. Only thing is the suite integration and this payroll control center in this feature group, whatever is there, you have to just study that specific new changes, and you have to see what are the impact in your EC payroll. So this will be happening for every half yearly activity, every 6 months. SAP will be releasing not only for EC payroll, for all other modules of SuccessFactor. So as a payroll consultant, it is your responsibility to inform your customers saying these are the new changes have came up, and you would like to show a demo in that, if you any part of the impact of those changes if you're doing in the system. Okay, then you can proceed further. Yeah.
Is it every 6 months or is it every 3 months they make it?
No, now from this year onwards, from 2020, it will be 6 months. Previously, last year, it was every quarter, every 3 months it was there. But from this year onwards, it will be every 6 months. Now, current release in the just 2 days back, the new releases came up in June 2020. That is, we call first half of 2020. So it is called 1H 2020. And the second release will be coming around, say, November, December, it will come. I'm not aware of the exact date, but the first release just now, just 2 days back, it released. Okay. So in this way, you can keep update yourself as well as your customer. Okay. So this is regarding your what is new here, the second document. Third document is most important one. This is from an implementation point of view. So from an implementation point of view, there are eight documents. Those are also in the part of 1S 2020 release. Here, the most important, the first one, that is your ECP point-to-point integration. That is the most important document for us. okay, which we'll be talking about more into details in the part B, okay. And the second other one, other documents like time off, time sheet, time information, working time information, country specific. So these are actually up to you whether you have implement, you are implementing time off or time sheet or not. Depending upon that, you have to go through that document. But from EC payroll point of view, if you are implementing, then we have to think of like whether this integrations, what are the integration points. Only those things we'll be discussing in our session. Not will not be going deep dive into time off and time sheet because those are part of your EC time off and EC time sheet. Okay, but from an EC payroll point of view, what are the integration points? What are those specific configurations we have to do? Okay, that will be going through. Okay, so these are the different 8 documentations which is already there in the all-in-one guide which I have shared with you. Okay, so that you can find it there. The next one is the integration document. So there are integration documents. There are 3 documents. One is your BSI. That is specific for US payroll only, and you will not be getting any questions from there. Whenever you are applying for certification, you will not be getting questions from BSI. Rather, the next 2 documents, that is your SuccessFactors EC with Kronos Workforce Central and your Employee Central with Workforce Software, these 2 integrations, you will be getting questions from your in your certifications. Okay. So from a certification point of view, these second two documents are important. But if you're working in US payroll, then you have to refer this BSI SAS document. Okay. That is the thing. The next one is the operational activity. So when it comes to operational activity, there are 2 documents. So you do not have to take care of it because it is more related to your IT infrastructure team and your SAP based system. They will be working. So any kind of disaster is happening in your operation, day-to-day operation in your payroll, or any contractual related queries are there, okay? So your client IT team will be referring this document, but it is good to go through, but it is not mandatory. From a certification point of view, this is not mandatory to go through this document, okay? So these are all documents which I have just bundled together in the same all-in-one guide. And along with that, I have added more documents into that, okay? So you can go through those. Out of 3,400, around 2,000 pages are from SAP official document. So we can, whenever you're getting time, just go through, okay? So any questions regarding your documentations, Nabdi, before we start our practical session?
No.
Okay. So I know this is very huge document. I generally go whatever is as and when required, but I never read one, to be frank and honest with you. I never read one by one, line by line of this all the document except the certification part. Okay, the certifications which is there in the implementations part. Okay, because in when it comes to the certifications, only specific topics will be coming. Not all these documents will be required. Only part is I will just highlight. Just from discover phase, nothing will be coming. From your what is new, you'll be not getting any questions. And from implementation point of view, this first document. Okay. Employee Central payroll using point-to-point integrations and time off time sheet integration with ECP. These 3 initial 3 documents will be important for you. And when it comes to integrations, you will not be getting any question from BSI, only from the Kronos and Workforce Software, each and every. So for these 2 documents, you have to read each and every word.
Those documentations are separate or they're just part of this one documentation?
No, all what I have done for your ease of learning. So I have done, I have combined everything in a single document, and that index, which page you have to refer. Yesterday, I have already discussed that. That indexing also I have done. Like in this index, if you see, in this index, I have mentioned out of these 3,400 pages. Okay. So which page onwards, which document. Okay. So that I have a single. Suppose I would like to go for, what is new viewer. Okay. So that is in the line number 8, which is there in the 453. That is 2-page document.
I just have to follow that.
When I study. Yes. Yeah. So whenever you're studying, just keep in, take a printout of this index, I will suggest, or take a note of it. Okay. So after that, you just, whenever you are facing any issues or any, you have focused, because I also highlighted the dark in a bold color, which are actually relevant for certifications. Okay. So which are the highlighted one, those are the, you have to prioritize. Okay. Other than that, other document, you just read it in a.
Index is available on what page? What is the page number for this one? Or is this 168 or?
Which one?
The one screen we are seeing right now.
Okay. Okay, great. What so this screen is not there because it is, I think it is not there. So I'll be just up these two slides I'll be sharing with you separately. Okay. So do not worry about it. So these two slides I'll be sharing with separately because till page number 24219 remains same. And every time I update it towards the end. Okay. So for that reason, around extra 1000 pages.
So I don't have those indexes there, like these two pages, it's not there.
No, these two pages are not there because I have updated just 2-3 days back. Okay, so it is not there. So anyway, towards the end, what I will do at present, you just go through the serial number which I have mentioned here as per the slides. I am sharing the slides with you, and other than that, towards the end, I'll be updating this presentation again. The total all-in-one guide I'll be updating again, and I'll be just updating last line. The last page number, article number 27, line number 27. This one I'll be operating and accordingly we'll plan it. So at present, you just go through this document. I will suggest to go through the initial 200, 300 pages because that will take some time because there's a lot of learning materials are there. Okay. So today, what I will do, I will just showing you the this practical aspect of it. Okay, those whatever you've studied till now, okay, the practical of EC payroll administrator, the EC payroll administrator, what are the practical activities you have to do that we'll be seeing now. Okay, okay. So the before we start the lab session, I will tell you what are the things actually we'll be doing today. So first in the first assignment, we'll be doing the role-based permission for an HR admin. Okay. So what are the different activities and as an HR admin you will be doing and what are the RBP for that we'll be discussing, and that you can directly access the how to do this thing even if you are not having a recording still. Anyway, this one I will be recording anyway. So page number, if you go to 181, directly you will be getting the step-by-step process. Okay, so whatever we are seeing now, okay, so everything will be seeing with a single step-by-step in the, like all the baby steps they have given, like you have to go there, you have to go manage permission role, you have to take action. So all these steps they have given, okay. But what I'm going to show you, I'll be showing you directly in the my system, okay, which is there. Okay.
So these are on what page number?
Pages are in the 181, page number 181 onwards. You'll be around 100 to around 150 pages. You'll be finding all these practical aspect of it, all the practical applications, whatever the RBP, okay, related to EC or EC payroll administrator, you will be getting there. You got it?
Mm-hmm.
So I will suggest you just go through this because it's still 181 pages still you have to catch up. Okay, so we'll be seeing all these things. Let me log into the system and I will show you how it looks like.
So when are you going to get access to the system?
Okay, so I'll be giving that access, that SF admin access to you. Okay, and that will be valid for say 2 months. Okay, so in that we have to practice everything. So first activity will be your setting of your permissions for your HR system administrator. So who is an HR system administrator, what are the roles he will be accessing, and we have to go through that. Okay, so from a SAP point of view, just let me log in the system. So I may have to stop recording and I will record it again. So because I will be logging into the system.
This conference will now be recorded.
So the first assignment which we are performing now, so that is your lab assignment one, which is a setting of a RBP for an HR admin. So it is not very specific to your EC payroll. Rather, I will say a person who is taking care of EC admin, he can also perform this activity. Okay. The main motive behind this is we have to give an SAP system configuration access. Okay, so for that reason, in the exercises one file, in this presentation also I have given this screenshot which roles to be given and which permissions to be given. Okay, so whenever you are a person is having a system admin role, the same person can be a, we call it HR admin, or the same person can be an EC admin. Okay, people call it different by different name, but the main motive behind this practical exercises is to give the access to to the SAP system configuration. Okay, so if you're having this SAP system configuration, you will be having access to the backend system as well. Okay, when I say backend system, that is on-premise SAP HCM system, which is nothing but your EC payroll. Okay, so for how to do that, so we'll be just going to this admin center, and after going to admin center, we have to go to the manage permission roles. Okay, so I will go to manage permission role. Okay, so after going to manage permission role, what I can do, I will just at present I have already created those admin role, system admin role. Otherwise, I can, what I can do, like you can see, there is an HR admin for employees. So first I will show you whatever I have already created. Then it is very simple, like you have to just create a role, and I will show you how it is done. So this is which I have already created. What is an assignment for you is, like I'll be sharing with you this instance, and you have to practice this as well. As per the this job aid, which I'll be, this is in your all-in-one guide, page number 180 onwards, you have to follow the exact steps they have mentioned in this, okay? Then you have to perform these activities. Okay, so HR admin for employees, suppose I'm going there, and if I go to the permission here, in the permission setting, so there are two types of permission. One is your user permissions, another is your administrator permissions, okay? So if I go to the inside of your user permissions, you'll be finding here SAP system configurations, okay? So one is your SAP system configuration. Second one you'll be finding here, manage SAP system configuration. So manage SAP system configuration, if you go, that will be coming under your this admin permission, manage SAP system configuration. Let's check where it is. Manage SAP system configurations. Yeah, so this is your setup configuration, manage SAP system configuration. So at present, I have not given access to this HR admin. What I will do, so in a typical HR admin role, the person who will be handling your EC payroll as well, so you have to give this access to him. Okay, so that is the objective of this practical exercises. Unless and until you are not giving access to this, even if the person is an HR admin, he will not be having this access to your EC payroll system administration, system configurations. Okay, so that is the only first lab exercises. Okay, so once you are given this access, then that particular user, the HR admin who will be responsible for that, okay, he will be able to now execute whatever the SAP system configuration, backend configuration, this he can do it. Okay, this is very simple. You have to go to admin permission, and under that you have to select manage SAP system configuration. Okay, the same thing I have just put it in the screenshot as well here in this presentation, and same has been explained into whatever I have explained in very short, so that they have explained into say 4-5 pages they have taken, and they're step by step. It is very easy to follow. You have to just go to manage SAP system configuration, and you have to scroll it again, so you have to just click that specific permissions. Okay, so that you can follow here. Okay, that is the first configurations. Once it is done, the next activity which you will be doing, the next set of permission is your payroll integration permission. Okay, so that is your next step. So you can see in the presentation as well, I have mentioned it, payroll integration permission. Okay, unless and until this payroll integration permission is there, you can't give the person who is running the payroll or doing the configuration related to the payroll, he or she will not be able to perform this specific task assigned to him. So what I will do now, next one is payroll integration permission. I have to go to payroll integration permission. So it is very simple. There is something called payroll integration permission, I have to select that. And here under payroll integration permissions, there are a lot of things. In the right hand side, if you see, so if it is a person is an HR admin and all, so you have to select everything like data replication proxy, employee payroll run results. Okay, suppose depending upon your client requirement as well. Okay, suppose if the HR admin is not responsible for performing these things, okay, whatever the person's requirement, only those specific permission you can give. you have to talk to your client. What are the permissions to be given to the data replication permission or data replication proxy? Okay, so those things you will be performing here. Okay, and so data replication, so just user select whatever is required here. Okay, then data replication means whatever the employee data has been maintained in your, say, EC employee central, it will be updating in your EC payroll. Similarly, your cost center data, whatever you are maintaining in your finance, that will be moving to your EC payroll accordingly. Okay, so for that reason, this data replication and data replication proxy is required. Okay, so depending upon your scenario and all, you have to just select all these permissions. So this is as per the SAP best practices. You have to just give these permissions to the HR admin and whatever is required for you. Okay, so once it is done, you have to just click done, and you have to then save it. Okay, so this is your first activities which you will be performing for an HR admin. Okay, so same thing you will be finding in this job aid or this step-by-step process you will be finding here. Okay, so once it is done, so then you have to select who is the target audience. So for this particular role, who are my target? So target will be generally the every employee. Suppose if you are implementing EC payroll for every employee in your organizations, okay, so then you have to just scroll it, and you mention those target populations here, like saying grant this role to. Okay, so in the section 3 you will be finding these options, grant this role to. So you can see it has been the target has, audience has been a lot, like I've given this permission to HR admin or payroll administrator. I've given this permission to countries like Japan, Australia, Germany, depending upon how many number of countries I have presence in my company has presence. Okay, so I have to just go to there, and I have to just select the to whom I would like to grant the permissions. Okay, and in the specified target, suppose I would like to give it to everyone. Okay, so then I can just select everyone. Otherwise, depending upon your requirement, no, only for a specific department or specific targeted audience you would like to give, accordingly you can, depending upon your requirement, business requirement, you have to set up that. Okay, so in this way you can set up the initial RBP setup, the role-based permission setup for your HR administrator in a typical EC payroll scenario. So any questions here in this exercises?
I'm okay so far.
Okay, it is very simple, nothing much here. So again, this is a nothing different from your EC RBP. Okay, the second thing is regarding the RBP for a payroll system manager. Okay, the second level assignment will be, suppose as I was mentioning, there are two types of major role in your EC payroll implementation. One is your payroll system manager, second one is your payroll system administrator. Okay, so payroll system administrator, he will be a subject matter expert. He'll be doing everything, all the troubleshooting part and the query resolution, or mostly the alert resolution. But payroll system manager, he is mostly responsible for performing those operational activity, running a payroll, running the finance posting, running the off-cycle payroll run. So for him to make the activities of payroll system manager successful, so we have to set off this permission. So he will be having this particular permission. In this particular permission, what are the access he will be given? Okay, so like here I have mentioned, from a payroll integration permission point of view, he should be given this PCC configuration, PCC data maintenance task, payroll system assignment. On the top of that, he will be having some specific in the payroll control center. If I go to the payroll control, suppose I'll be showing you this in the system, rather it will be very clear to you. So let me go back to the payroll system manager or payroll process manager role. I'll just highlight which is important for you. That is, from a certification point of view also questions comes, like which are the activities a payroll process manager typically do. Okay, so I'll go to manage permission role. So at present, I do not have any payroll process manager. Okay, so what I'm going to do, or payroll system manager rather, I will say. So this is a role for, say, PCC payroll system manager. I will just create a role called payroll system manager. payroll system manager. You can write a brief description about the permission. Okay, so, but for time being, I'm just mentioning the role name only. Then the permission setting, which are the important permissions to be given, that is your payroll integration permission. Okay, so this payroll integration permission always there, like your data replication configurations, your payroll run results. As an employee or as a payroll process manager, I must be able to run this, all these things, employee, payroll, run, okay? And I must be able to replicate, means I should have like authorization for this replication configuration as well, okay? So when it comes to payroll run results, you should be able to view, correct, create, okay? Adjust anything or delete anything, okay? So those permissions, depending upon the requirement, you can give. When it comes to the payroll control center configurations, it may not happen like payroll process manager will not be responsible for configuration. Rather, this access should be given to a consultant, payroll consultant or support consultant or the payroll system administrator. You can provide this access. But again, it is very specific to your client. If they require it, you can provide it. Because if it is a small organization, the same person is performing the role of, say, payroll system manager as well as the payroll system administrator, you should have given access to everything. Okay. So otherwise, as per the SAP best practices, SAP recommends, you have to give these payroll center, control center configurations, data maintenance to some extent, and payroll system assignment. Okay, so these are the 2 to 3 permissions which you have to give. Say data maintenance, it is an important activity as well when it comes to the payroll. Okay, same goes with your payroll system assignment. Okay, so just to follow this guideline which I have presented in this page PPT, as well as also it is there in your guide. Okay. So one, this is from a payroll integration permission point of view. Next one is a payroll control center. Okay. So when I say payroll control center, there are a lot of activities, a lot of tasks you'll be seeing. My alert, my processes, unassigned alert, managed processes. The easiest way to remember is wherever it is written alert, like your my alert and unassigned alert, alerts are never given to the payroll system manager. Because alert is always with your payroll system administrator. Your system administrator will be responsible for checking those alert and all. Okay, so for that reason, in this presentation, you'll be finding the next slide. I have given this 4 only, mostly this my processes, manage policies, and my ops cycle. So these 4 activities or these 4 process steps, you'll be given access as a payroll process manager or payroll system manager. Okay. This is an ideal way. Okay, so you can give it as per your client requirement, but as per the SAP recommendations, this 4 access should be given with your payroll system manager. Okay, so once it is done, so you can go for SAP system configurations, you can provide this access as well. So once it is done, just click done. Then next is your adding this role. So you can provide this role to a specific permission group, say payroll admin or any other administrator, you can provide it. Then you can put it target population. If suppose it is applicable for all employees, then you just choose everyone, then click done. Okay. So in this way, you can set up an RBP for your payroll system manager or the payroll process manager. Okay, it's not very difficult. Okay, so this is the way you have to follow. And how about I will recommend in the next step. So this is here regarding your exercise number 2, which you have already seen it here. Okay. So similar, the same process you can repeat. So what I will suggest you. So in the for payroll administrator, the process will be remain the same, whatever the activities we have seen. But only thing is this tick box will be different. Okay. This instead of my processes, manage processes and everything, you have to select the remaining things, the tick box. Okay. That is for your payroll system administrator. Okay. So these are the 3 major roles when it comes to the RBP. So you'll be finding all these things. Okay. So what I will recommend, once the session is over today, just navigate through these particular RBP. Okay. And you just go through the system access which I'll be providing with you. Okay. So once you go through, then you'll be able to more confident regarding that. Okay. So exercise number 3, actually I'm not discussing because it is the same thing. Only thing is additional. So you've just created another role. And after payroll process administrator or payroll system administrator, only thing which changes will be doing in this payroll control center, you have to just select my alert, as well as your unassigned alert. Okay, and remaining things also manage teams and my teams access. You can give everything also. Okay, but ideally payroll system administrator is not given this running payroll access is not given to him. Okay, but again depends upon your client. But as per the best practices, my alert, unassigned alert, manage team and my team, it is, these four things will be always with your payroll system administrator or the payroll process administrator. The same person, he will be having all these roles as a system because he is a subject matter expert in a typical AC payroll implementations. Okay. So any questions regarding these three roles? Are you clear on these three roles?
No. That's it.
What is the query? Any questions? What is the questions? Doubt, any doubt?
So you're saying the alerts are only given to the payroll administrator?
Yes.
Only, yeah.
That is the ideal way. Okay. But there are some scenarios which I have also seen. Like suppose if it is a small organization having 200 employees. Okay. So only one person is having conducting, means doing all the payroll activities. So in these scenarios, then you can't segregate between these three roles, like payroll system manager, payroll administrator. Rather, the same person will be performing every activities. Okay, so in those cases, those are exceptional cases where exactly the same person will be one man army and he'll be performing everything. Okay, so serving the alert, running the payroll, everything he'll be doing. But if it's a larger organization, say more than at least 1,000 employees or 2,000 employees you are having, so in those cases, mostly we have two persons dedicated for your payroll. Then one person play the role of your payroll process manager or payroll system manager. Another person can play the role of your payroll system administrator. In this way, you can segregate these two roles. Okay. So what I will suggest you, I think you have not gone through those PTO guide. In the PTO guide itself, I'll just take you through where exactly it is there. Okay. So if you go to the PTO guide, in the PTO guide, they have clearly mentioned what is the role of your payroll system manager, payroll process administrator. Okay. So all these things you'll be finding here, like here, they have mentioned these two roles, like payroll manager and the payroll administrator. Okay, so these two roles, so you have to go through. Okay, so then you will be clarity, it will clarify your doubts. Okay, so I would recommend to go through that specific permission. As I was mentioning, administrator permissions and your administrator level, like as I was mentioning, payroll manager, payroll administrator. You just go through this PTO guide, then you'll be more clear, means it is more theoretical. And you have to just go through it, then you will be able to relate it. Whatever you are doing in the practical, the lab session, like what are the permissions we are giving, but it is very flexible. SAP has recommended this so and so, but whenever you are having, so here I'm giving the example, whatever I have shown to you, right? This administrator permission, okay, which I have shown to you in the system, okay? So here in this permission setting, you can see, and there are six different interfaces. So as an administrator, as a payroll administrator, I must have access to everything. Like my alert, my process, unassigned alert, everything, I must have access to this, okay? So in this way, you can have, it will be very clear once we go through this PTO guide, the page number 19 and subsequent pages onwards, okay? So when it comes to the payroll data maintenance tasks, so as an administrator, I must be able to maintain sometime the task as well, that an application monitor, I should have access. I sort of access to the payroll unified configurations, okay, which you have seen yesterday. So those, all these configurations access must be given, okay, to an administrator. So this PTO guide you can refer, and then if you are studying that, if you are going through that job aid, that is your practical application, how we are performing those required permissions, then it will be more, you'll be getting more clarity, okay. So first few pages you'll be finding. It is for your HR system administrator. As an HR system administrator, what are the permissions to be given to me? Okay. So, and why it is given? So, how it is given? So, all those details you'll be finding in this job aid. Okay. So, once it is done in the next page number 191 onwards, what are the permissions to be given to a payroll system manager? Okay. So, those details also you'll be finding here. Like these are the different permissions, say, for a payroll system manager. Okay. So, you have to go to the payroll control center. You have to just then. As I am a payroll system manager, I should be given access to these few steps only, not everything. My process, or manage process, manage policies. So I should not be given those alert. Okay. So I already highlighted this one in your this all-in-one guide. Okay. So what are the different permissions to be given? Okay. And what are the activities? Suppose if you are setting those permissions, what it will do? Suppose I am given a my process access, it will enable user with a role to use the payroll process. Okay, so what are the relevance of this each and every line items you'll be finding in this guide, okay, which says if you are setting up these permissions and all, it is very step by very clear. Okay, so you'll be finding all the details about it, but at the same time I have also shown to the in the system as well. So how we'll be configuring this RBP for a system payroll system manager. Okay, and same is true for your payroll administrator as well. The initial three documentations in this job aid, you'll be finding how to set up the RBP for three different roles. One is your HR system administrator, another is your payroll system manager, third one is your payroll system administrator. Okay, so all these three are now major roles. Out of these, two are major roles, where payroll system administrator as well as your payroll system manager. So these two are the major roles in a typical EC payroll implementation project. Okay, so that you can set up by following this guide, which I have already shown to in the system, as well as also I presented in the presentation as well. Okay, so I will recommend, without studying you will not be able to understand, but I will recommend to study those in detail. Okay, at the same time I will give you access to the system, you can start practicing these three things. Okay, so shall we go to the next assignment?
Sure,
if you do not have any questions. Okay, so next assignment is regarding how to configuring the SAP system. Okay, so for SAP system configuration, it is an interesting one. So what do you mean by SAP system configuration? Why do you need it? Okay, as you know, EC payroll is a runs on your on-premise system, that is your ESP7 on-premise system. Okay, and your SuccessFactors, it is a completely cloud product. So we have to establish a connection between these two. Okay, so how to set up that connection? So there is something called SAP system configuration in the sales demo. If I go in my instance, if I go to SAP system configurations, let me go there. I'll simply start typing saying SAP system configuration. As soon as I start typing SAP system configuration, I'll just click that SAP system configuration, and I will navigate to there. Okay, so now I'm in front of my SAP system configurations. In the search bar, I have to just click SAP. There is only one thing, that is your SAP system configuration. I have to go there. Once I've selected, so there is a predefined, like for this system in the sales demo instance, I have already configured them. I'm coming to that point, how to configure it. But there is a system, there is an SAP system which is having instance number 410. That is the client ID is 410. Okay, so here you'll be finding, this is the system name which is I have already configured, X0B410, and this is my system URL. So what is the meaning of this URL? This URL will be provided by SAP. Okay, so whenever you are having your EC payroll implementation, your SAP will be providing three different URLs. One is for development, one is for quality, one is the production. Okay, so this URL will be receiving from SAP, and they will also provide this client ID. It can be your 200 client, it can be 300 client, it can be 800 client, depending upon your whether it's a quality or production. Okay, so this URL you have to get it from SAP, and once you receive it, because I've already configured in the system, otherwise what you can do, suppose if it has not been configured, so you have to just ignore this thing. Okay, only thing is directly there is right hand side, there is something called create new. Okay, so in the create new you have to go there, and there is something called SAP system configuration. Once I click SAP system configuration, these three fields will be blank, like the system name, system URL, and then this client ID. Suppose my client ID is 200 and my system URL, I have received say XYZ HTTPS. So the typical configuration will be like that only. And system name, this one also SAP will be providing, whether it is an EC payroll quality or EC payroll production, accordingly you can define it here. Okay, and the system URL will be like HTTPS, your, this is a typical format, and my, then particular number will be there. Okay, there is a particular number which will be client specific. Then the typical structure will be like payroll dot on demand, because we call it EC payroll is on demand payroll. Okay, so payroll on demand.com. So this is a typical structure of your system URL. Okay, whenever you are configuring the SAP system configuration. Okay, so once we do it, once you have done, then you have to just click save it. Okay, in this way you can set up this kind of SAP system configurations and all. This URL will be provided by SAP, and same thing will be provided by system name also, it will be provided. So once it is done, you'll be seeing there is something called successfully saved it to the store. Then accordingly, if you like to see that again directly now in the drop down value, I can get in my system. Okay, previously only one value was there, x0p410. Now I can see there are two values coming up. Okay, suppose if you like to change anything, because this is just a dummy value I have created, suppose if you like to change it, I have to just go there and I have to take action and make correction. Okay, so then again I have to make any changes, whatever is required for me. Okay, and this is a one-time activity. Once you get your system, this is a one-time activity. You do not have to do it repetitively. Okay, so once your system is provided for one time for your preview system and another time for your production environment. Okay, so you'll be getting these two different URL from SAP. Then you have to just establish these connections by going to this SAP system configuration. It is very simple. You have to just type SAP system configuration in the search bar of actions, and you have to just configure it for the, whenever you're doing for the first time, you have to click this create new button. And you have to start, and you have to maintain this URL, system name, and the client ID. It is very simple. Any queries here, Navdeep?
No, I'm okay.
It is very simple. Yeah. So once you are done with this one part, first part of your configuring your SAP system. Once this connection has been established, the next step. What is my next step? So the next step is payroll process configurations. Okay. So for that, I have to start typing payroll process configuration here in the search bar. I have to go to there, payroll process. Payroll control center configurations. Yeah. So this is a payroll controls, payroll process configuration. They call it payroll process configuration. Okay. But you can find it by the name payroll control center configuration. Okay. So once you go there, you will be finding something called in search bar. Only one option is there, payroll control center configurations. Okay. So once it is done, then you will be finding here the system which you have access. Okay. The same system which I am having, the X0B410, which I have already configured previously. So if any correction is required, you can always make a correction in the take action bar. Okay, so here you can see the past system name which you have seen just before this. So if you would like to view that SAP system configuration, you just click this card, which just before this configuration I have configured, means we have configured this X0B410. Okay, similarly the another system name, as we are having, suppose another system, the ECP QAS, okay, the quality system. Okay, I can choose that as well. I can find out the detailed configuration in this card. Okay, so once I receive this, once I have done it, there are two things you'll be done. It is very simple. In this payroll processes, there are two button here, two drop down values. One is your payroll control center simply, and second one is the payroll control center classic. So what is the difference between two? So when PCC, when it comes to the payroll control center, it is not a very new concept. It is started already in the 2012-13. Okay, but it was not very mature at that point of time. So still some of the clients, they might be using this payroll control center classic with limited functionality, but at present we are dealing with the first one, the payroll control center, which is the more simplified version. It is more consistent across. Okay, so you always, whenever you are doing the configuration, this is again one time configuration. Okay, so you have to always choose the payroll control center, not the classic one. Okay, and same is applicable for your payroll error also. So in the payroll error column also, you will be finding two options. One is your payroll control center, another is your payroll control center classic. So you have to avoid the classic one. So you have to always use this payroll control center only. Okay, so once you have done, so this is the way your SAP system configuration is established. Okay, so that is your second activity whenever you are performing here in this SAP system configuration. This slave assignment 4 is all about how to configure the SAP system. So we have seen SAP system configuration as well as your payroll process configuration, that is the payroll control center configuration. So how to assign these things and how to choose. Okay, so the latest version is the payroll control center, not the classic one. Okay, so we have to always choose this payroll control center only. Okay, this is our the lab assignment 4. Okay, and this is also already been explained in your, if you go through the your guide, your all-in-one guide. Okay, so you'll be finding here page number 213 onwards, couple of pages, you'll be finding all this detailed explanation, how to go there, how to navigate to that. Okay, SAP system configuration, take action, make corrections, and whatever the relevant example can you can it has been given, you can refer this documentation. And the second part also they have given, the step number 20, payroll control center configuration. So actually the number of steps are more because they have gone very they have taken every baby steps. Okay, so like every step by step they have allowed. Okay, so which I have shown you in a very brief way. So they have gone through, suppose somebody is very new to SuccessFactors, still he has not, he or she is not having any knowledge, still he can follow and he can go through this. Okay, so this is what they have explained here. And yeah, so this is how the step number, the exercises number three, sorry, for exercise number four. Okay, configuring the SAP, how to configure an SAP system to set up this basic connections. Okay, so any queries here before we go ahead, which is very simple again, but you have to study.
Okay.
So this is again, you do not have to do it repetitively in a typical implementation project. This is a one-time activity you have to perform. Okay, but you have to ensure everything is the proper, like your system name is, your payroll process has been selected, control center and all. It's very simple.
Once you can do configuration, I have a question.
Yeah.
Once you have configuration, where would you see them? Like in the front end? Like where would you?
Okay. So okay. So I'll coming to that. So I'll be coming to that. If you are actually, this is a kind of, if you're not doing this configuration, you'll be getting some error. Okay. Like in the front end, in the sense, you'll be just, I will show you in the payroll control center. If I go to the payroll, say payroll. So in the payroll thing, you'll be seeing there are a lot of tabs here. My processes, my alert, unassigned alert, manage processes, manage policies, my obstacle, manage teams. So all these things you'll be getting here. Okay. But in the sales demo, the problem is you do not have an access to an on-premise access. Okay. So for that reason, it will be asking you an user ID and password. And you in the sales demo, they do not provide this user ID and password for the EC payroll system. Okay. So once you have access to this system, then you will be able to see whatever the connection we have established. That is a payroll processes, payroll, whatever, the payroll control center, we have configured everything. Okay. So the front end of your payroll control center will be looking like this. So anyway, I'll be showing to you another system. In the sales demo, you will not be having access to this. This is the payroll backend system. Okay. So after 10 minutes, I'll be showing you how that particular system will be looking like. Okay. So whatever you're configuring, you'll be finding here in this front end. Otherwise, you'll be getting any error. Suppose you have not established that connections, it will be saying system has not been assigned, okay, to a particular this instance and all. Okay, so those kind of error will be getting, but anyway, this will be once this connection is established, you'll be finding them in this front end. This is the front end of your payroll control center. Is that clear?
Okay, so that's in control center.
Yeah,
where did you go?
So this is your single interface. So I'll be.
Those are different systems.
So here, yeah, those are actually not. Actually, this is actually connection. So there is in the left hand side, there is a connection. You can see there is, it is just a gray or grayed out, but you can see X0B410, right? Can you see that? This X0B410. Why it is showing X0B410? Because we have established the connection. That is your previously, whatever we have seen, X0B410 has been connected. Okay. But in the sales demo, it is not purely connected. That is, your system is X0B, client is 410. But in the sales demo, you can't make this establish this connections, and SAP actually charges for that. If you want to have a connections backend system and all, they charge a lot, huge in terms of our hourly basis, they charge it. Okay.
So are for that reason,
Are
you going to show me later those one, like those system or?
That system actually I'll be able to show you, but that session will not be recorded. Okay, so it's a different system, but you will be getting this system only because that charges, there are extra, then SAP charges for that separately. Okay, So that is a different system which I can show you later on. Today after 10-15 minutes, I'll show you that, okay, how it looks like.
This system is like SAP Prem or on-prem or?
This is actually, as the whatever you are seeing now, this is a best run sales demo instance. And when I go to the payroll, there is a connection between your, when I say X0B410, this is an EC payroll system, which is nothing but your on-premise. So once you are having this user ID and password, you will be able to connect to your on-premise, okay, on-premise EC payroll system. Then from there, you'll be able to access this My Process, My Alert, whatever it is there. Now once this connection is established, okay, whatever data has been updated in your backend system, that is your on-premise EC payroll system, those details you'll be able to fetch here. Okay? So that you'll be finding here. Anyway, I'll be showing that in the system. It will give you more clarity.
Can you do configuration directly on-prem system?
Yes, on-premise system, yeah. So the basic configuration will be always remain the same. That is your specific to your basic PA configuration, use your number range. Okay, those activities will be there. And those payroll control center entire configurations, you have to do in your on-premise.
Was it done the cloud base or? They're
okay.
done just regular ACP system.
Okay. So when I say regular ACP system, there are two ways of doing it. One is if you're having VPN connections, you can use your VPN connection and you can just log into the VPN connection and you just go to SAP GUI, SAP GUI, and you can do those configuration. Otherwise, you can have an option to go for a web GUI, web GUI, which is a cloud-based thing. Same thing means the steps will be configuration steps are same, the backend system remains the same. Only thing is you are accessing it through a cloud URL. Okay, so the cloud URL you are accessing that SAP GUI, whatever you used to do, access via SAP GUI. Okay, suppose if you're not, because in one of the projects I didn't have a VPN connection and the client didn't invest on the VPN, so we have to configure it completely on the cloud. Okay, so on the payroll, there's the URL which I was showing to you, right? The same URL we have to use, and all this basic waste type configuration, your schema configuration, your all those things we have done. I have done, in fact, in the web GUI itself directly. Okay, so that you can establish, but depending upon your client, whether the client has a VPN or not, then you can accordingly you can plan it. Okay. Any further queries?
No, I'm okay. Super.
Feel free, when it's even if you think it's a very stupid question, to don't be shy. Okay, so like, because everybody is learning some point of time, okay? So you just feel free, any questions, even if it is a very odd question, you can ask me, and there is no problem. So this is your regarding your exercise number 4, where we have seen this configuring, how to configuring the SAP system configuration, okay? So once it is done, the next activity which you'll be doing, like assigning this particular payroll system to the manager, who is the payroll manager, and the payroll system administrator. Okay, we'll be assigning the payroll system to how to assign to the payroll system. So I'll just now show you. So the configuration is very simple. So I have to go to the payroll system assignment. Okay, I have to just start typing payroll system assignment. Payroll system assignment. Once I go there, payroll system assignment, again I have to search, and here in this search bar you'll be finding different person's name. Okay, so the person's, suppose I'm choosing say Nandini Venkates, suppose she is responsible for certain activities for payroll. Okay, so what I'm going to do, I will just assign some system. So in this system I've already given access to this, so what I can do, suppose he is not given this system, so what I can do, in the create new I will go payroll system assignment. Okay, so I'll just assign this system name. Suppose recently I have created one new system, that is my ECP quality system. Okay, and by default the person should be given this access, say Nandini should be having access to this Nandini Venkates. So she should be given, so I think something is some data is missing. Otherwise, the particular username you have to select, whatever the username you will be getting here. Okay. Suppose let me put in some other person's file name. Because as you know, this is a sales demo. Many people have played a lot, and so you'll be getting a little inconsistency. Okay. Otherwise, you have just have to put the user assignment, and you have to just select the yes option here by default. Then automatically, whenever you are choosing that particular person, say I'm choosing say Nandini, then automatically he will be seeing those options like what are the system access has been given to that particular person. Okay, so here you can see for this particular person, Nandini Venkatesh, this payroll system, this X0B410, the system has been access has been given. Okay, and it is a by default system. Okay, so if you would like to see the system, you can just see the card here. It means which you have configured in the previous access IOS. Okay, so how to establish the SAP system configuration that we have seen there. Okay, so this URL, and after this just have to assign that particular username. So then that particular user will be responsible for that particular, he or she will be taking the ownership of that particular system. Okay, so in this way you can assign a particular payroll system to a particular user as well. Okay, whoever is the payroll administrator or payroll process manager. Okay, so you can see the same similar example. I have just chosen my username, and I have given this access to my this X0B410 system. Okay, so in this way also you can try it, and you can give the specific payroll system assignment to a particular user. Okay, so this is regarding your payroll system assignment. Any queries here? This is very simple again. No questions. So then we can move on to the next exercises. Next exercise is very simple again, like setting up the payroll tasks. Okay. So when I say payroll tasks, what are the different payroll tasks available for a typical payroll administrator? Okay. So how to establish those tasks? So actually this is a slide which I'll show you. It's a little spot. So that we can find it under your payroll unified configuration. Suppose I'm going to payroll unified configuration. Okay, so in this payroll unified configuration, you'll be finding one thing is how many number of countries you are implementing. Only those country you have to activate. Okay, suppose you are doing for Canada. Okay, suppose say Canada I'm implementing. So here, as we have established the connection, right, the X0B410. Okay, so automatically whenever you are choosing say X0B410, automatically that payroll system URL and system client ID will be coming here. Suppose I have chosen instead of that ECP QAS, okay, automatically that 200 client and this particular URL will be chosen. Okay, so depending upon your system, you'll be establishing these connections and all. Okay, and you have to make this status as an active. Once it is done, okay, this connection has been done, so you have to just click save option here. Okay? So this is how your payroll unified configuration has been done. And from a payroll task point of view, what are the things we'll be doing here? I'll just explain. It will take some time to save. Okay, so in the payroll task list, so if I go to the payroll task here, okay, so depending upon your event, okay, suppose you are having a promotion in event, or say any particular event, employee event you are having in your payroll, or say employee central, so you have to configure that event, means in your employee central as well, as usual. Then after that, in this particular event, what are the data you are going to update? Okay, that list you will be getting here. Suppose during an employee transfer, you would like to update his transfer data as well as some particular specific which is relevant your for your say payroll only those info types. So these are nothing but your info types. Okay, so like your tax assignment for Canada. So you must be aware of these info types in Canada, like 66 is of garnishment claim, So these are the different input types. Suppose if you are going to update during a typical your employee transfer event, okay, then in this configuration you have to assign those specific input types. Okay, so accordingly you will be, whenever you are having that particular employee event, you have to select this, okay, specific input types. Then you have to, whenever you are implement, whenever you are updating those data, you'll be getting those specific steps. Okay, whenever this particular payroll task will be getting updated. Okay, so in this way you have to, this particular task is all about how to update your specific single task for a particular employee event. Okay, so this is your second last steps, like before, whenever you're hiring an employee, how to set up the payroll task. Okay, only thing is you have to go to the payroll task and you have to, whatever the employee event is there, accordingly you have to mention those specific input types. What are the different input types you are going to update? Okay, that is regarding your assignment number 6. And same thing also you'll be finding in your all-in-one guide. If you go to the all-in-one guide, so setting up a complete payroll hiring, you'll be finding here. So just I'll suggest to go through this. Okay, so complete payroll tasks and those unified configurations, you'll be finding all those things. Okay, so this is regarding your assignment number 6. The next one is your setting up a new employee. This one I'm skipping it because it is nothing to do with your EC payroll, rather how to hire a new employee. Okay, so this one you can do it yourself, how to hire a new employee. You already know it, how to add a new employee in Employee Central. Nothing much here. Yes, just for your understand revision, they have mentioned it, how to add a new employee. Suppose you are new to EC, then for those people, then they will be performing this activity, how to add a new employee in EC. Okay, so all those detailed job information, compensation information, everything will be filled up. Okay, so in this way you have to fill up, you have to complete this assignment for how to hire a new employee. This is regarding your lab assignment number 7. Okay, so next one is your complete payroll hiring. So what is the meaning of a payroll hiring? So we have seen one part of it. Okay, the configuration which we have seen, that is your payroll task related to it. Okay, so how to do a complete payroll hiring means, suppose your payroll related data is not yet updated. So in those cases, you have to just go to the same employee and update your payroll specific data, say the compensation or anything, pay scale area, pay scale grouping, or any other pay components is eligible for. Okay, so in this assignment, actually you will be just going to the particular employee and you will be updating those specific payroll related info types or the payroll related components in your pay components in your EC payroll. Okay, so nothing much here. Lab assignment 8 also very simple, the way you have mentioned. Okay, now comes the interesting part, the lab assignment 9, 10 onwards. This is regarding your PCC, which I was talking about, right? PCC one click monitoring, that is a pre payroll activities, how to run a simulation payroll run, that I will show you in a different system. And the same is goes with your how to resolve an alert. Okay, how to run a production payroll run. Okay, similarly how to manage a processes and how to manage policies. So these things I'll be showing you. Okay, before that, one exercise is there, which is there for your granting standard user access to payroll information page. Okay, so this one actually is nothing but your payroll information page, which you'll be getting here. Suppose I am going to payroll information, I'm just typing payroll information, payroll system information. It is nothing but how to get access to the payroll system information. If I go there, so this one also you will not be able to see here. I'll be showing in a different system. Okay, so because it's OAuth integration, there is an integration is missing in the Employee Central and Employee Central payroll in the sales demo. Okay, so that will be showing in another system. So this is the connection point where exactly you'll be having this user access to information page. Other than that, there are certain things called off-cycle payroll run. So instead of going to the on-premise system, off-cycle related transaction, you can directly run the off-cycle payroll run in the Employee Central payroll control center front end. Okay, and when it comes to the off-cycle, there are two types of off-cycle. One is your ad hoc off-cycle, another is the planned off cycle. So ad hoc off cycle means it can be at any time. Okay, like your some accidental activity happened in your organization for employee, so you can provide those he needs some immediate advance pay, advance money. Okay, so payroll agent advance. So in those cases, the SAP have been the payroll administrator has to run ad hoc payroll and ad hoc off-cycle payroll run, or it can be a bonus, or it can be depending upon your scenario, you have to run this ad hoc off-cycle. Similarly, you have an option. So whenever you are having, an off-cycle payroll, you'll be getting this kind of screen. Okay. Suppose if you are running for one employee, okay, you have to go to that particular employee. You'll be getting a URL like this or a screen like this. Then you have to just mention the reason. Suppose if it is a special payment or any correction payment, depending upon your scenario, you can configure this scenario. And suppose it's a holiday bonus. Okay, so you can select and you'll be getting this kind of screen. Like you have to run this off-cycle payroll run for that particular employee. And then you have to, it will generate your off-cycle pay slip, and it, the particular employee will be paid that particular amount. Okay. This is how a typical ad hoc off-cycle looks like. But there is something called productive or planned off-cycle payroll run as well. Okay. So this is a typical payroll control center screen, which it looks like. Okay. So in this planned or productive planned off-cycle payroll, suppose if you've already planned for so and so month, so and so employee will be getting so and so much of money. Okay. There's a planned off-cycle payment. It can be a it can be a bonus payment, or it can be any other reason as well. Or any kind of reimbursement, any kind of thing. So you can plan. Tell me.
Are you show me like an example for the off cycle?
I will show that. I will show that in the tomorrow session. Okay. So what I will do for you tomorrow session, we'll be starting with this, which are the four steps which I will told you, right? These are the four things which is not there in the sales demo, you can't access. So those four or five things, like your pre-payroll, that is your lab assignment number 9, 10, 11, 12 and your 13. These are 14. So these are the 15, 16. So these things I can show you tomorrow in my system. Okay. So then you will be able to relate it. But at present, this is how the typical screens will be looking like. Like whenever you're running an off-cycle payroll run, so once we are doing the posting of that particular payroll run, okay. So you have to release the posting document, transfer the posting document. Okay. So all these things, this is how a typical steps will be looking like. But anyway, this one I'll be going to show you tomorrow session. Okay. So till 16, assignment number 16, once it is done, then your part, your EC payroll administrator, that part will be over. Okay. So then we'll be moving to the part B. Okay. So before we go to part B, I'll be having a small quiz for you. Okay. So just to check your knowledge. Okay. So in the meanwhile, I will suggest, as you are having enough time, I would recommend to go through the guide. Okay, so it is very important. Okay, so you just go through the guide at least once. Okay, so till I think till page number 381. Just a minute. Yeah, so I think it is till page number 389. Okay, that is a part A. Page number 1 to page number 389. That is part A, which is your admin guide. Okay, admin guide including your step-by-step process. Okay, so even if you are not having access to directly those system directly, you can go through those, go through the recording which I have told you, and accordingly you have to also go through this screenshot at least. Okay, so these are the same steps. This is actually very clear. Like they have mentioned every single steps in the step-by-step. Okay, I will show you anyway. These are the four or five exercises which I can't show you in the sales demo. That I will show you tomorrow, and then we will move to tomorrow. Actually, I'll be focusing on this remaining part, those 6 or 7 steps, which are the lab exercises we'll be completing. Okay, and you just prepare with your document, whatever the document I have said with you, initial 389 pages, and you write down your queries. As soon as you go, just a typical reading style. Actually, what I do generally when I go through this document, any of this document, I highlight, because it's a PDF document. Okay, so you can highlight immediately. Like whenever you're reading, I will recommend directly. You can just, suppose if you didn't understand a particular topic or a particular thing, you directly immediately highlight it here. Okay, you can highlight here, or you can make a note here also. Like you can put a chart like window and saying, I have a doubt on this tool search bar. I didn't understand what is this tool search bar. So in this way, we just maintain this note, and you just make a consolidated list whenever you are going through this document and all. And you just whether you can WhatsApp it, or you can tomorrow you can send a list of queries. Okay, or we can select, or you can make a pen and paper also. You can make a note of it while preparing. That's the best way. Okay, so you can do remember. Okay, so you can make a note of it, and you just we'll be having a Q&A session tomorrow. Okay, once I finish this this demo within half an hour, I will finish the remaining 6 demo in the another system. Then we will be jumping into the your queries. What are the queries you are having? Then we'll be having a short quiz tomorrow itself. Okay, is that fine?
Quiz on what?
Quiz in the very simple question I'll be asking, like whatever the topic which you have covered. Is it only 4 or 5 questions? Nothing much. Just like this, which are the standard roles for a payroll system administrator, as for the SAP recommendations. Okay, some few questions just for to check your knowledge. Nothing but there is no hard and fast. That's but this is a because very similar questions you'll be getting in your certifications and interview and all. So it will just to enforce your learning. Nothing much. Okay. Otherwise, I can share these questions with you. You can try it of your own, and you can answer to me directly. Okay, is that fine?
Okay, the last one you were discussing, page 39. I have to read from page 1 to page 39.
Page 1 to page 389.
What was about that? Like what you were telling? I missed that. Okay,
Spitil, whatever section, there are 3 sections, right? Just I will go back to my initial slides. I will tell you the learning.
Page 39, it'll be like a part A or something.
Till page number 389, it is your part A, which I was telling you in the initial session, right? That is your this one I was talking about. So ECP curriculum, can you see that?
Yeah.
Okay. So in the ECP curriculum, the part A, that is your Employee Central Payroll Administration completely. The part A will be till your page number 389. Okay, so whatever the document which I have shared with you. Okay, so even if you are not able to complete, because it is a, if you go through this, the initial 70-80 pages, it will be for PTO guide, followed by your specific to admin guide. Okay, so you can try to cover it, which is not a very difficult topic, because part B and part C are more complicated. Okay, part A is more of a end user. Okay, so it's a kind of admin. Suppose if you are an admin, what are the things? So I will suggest and recommend to go through a PTO guide, at least each and every word you must understand. Okay, so whatever they have explained here. Okay, so then after you complete your PTO guide, I think it is still 7 page number 72. Okay, so once you complete your PTO guide, then there is an admin guide. Okay, so this admin guide you must read. Okay, so this admin guide, again, there are certain things you already know it. Okay, it is not very new. Okay, so like in this, if you go to the structure of this admin guide, the part, there are different units. Unit 1 will be new for you, that is which I've already explained why we need and pay, what is the payroll, what is the payroll cycle, what is the different challenges in the on-premise payroll, why you are going for payroll control center. Okay, so those things are explained. And unit 2 is all about your RBP, whichever RBP we have discussed today, right? That RBP has been explained theoretically. Okay, and in this, whatever the exercises you will be seeing, right, this unit exercises, so this unit exercises are nothing but which I have shown you today. Okay, so do not have to worry about it. So like how to set up a RBP for a payroll system manager, how to set up a RBP for payroll administrator, how to configure this SAP systems. Okay, so once you go through it, so you, and at the same time if you go through the video as well, then you will be able to relate it, like yes, I have seen it in the today's session, and this is the, you can relate it and you can remember it in that way. Okay, that is your unit 2 is all about your RBP. Unit 3 is very simple. I have skipped it knowingly because you already know it. Okay, how to enter employee data, because it is part of your Employee Central, how to set up a new employee, how to set up those payroll data related topic. Okay, so those things, so how to update the employee related data, we'll be seeing here. Only one topic is there, that is for data replication monitor, which I'll be showing you later on, because it is means that is part of your part B anyway. Okay, so that will be seeing later on. Okay, after then that, the unit 4 is regarding your payroll control center, the front end, how the front end will be looking like tomorrow. If I will be showing this one, the unit number 4, okay, in the front end I'll be showing you. And unit number 5 is again, it is a employee central activities, like data maintenance, how to maintain those specific data for an employee, how as an employee, how he can update, how as a manager, he can update. Those are very basic things. So you can unit number 5, you can just read within 5-10 minutes, just like go through those pages and all, not very difficult to understand. Only thing is, in this part, in this documentation, you have to read thoroughly the unit one you have to read it thoroughly. Unit 2, you have to read it thoroughly. Unit 3, you can skip, or if you, because you are already knowing employee central basics, okay, how to add an employee, you can skip it. Unit 4, you have to read it, okay. Similarly, unit 5 and unit 3, you can skip it, okay. Like, this is a very simple one, okay. And other than that, there is an appendix. In the appendix section, you'll be finding like which are the different, if I go to the appendix part of the admin guide, you will be finding this. Let me go to the appendix. What are the countries available at present? You will be getting there, but depending upon your localizations, okay. So which are the countries at present available in your EC payroll scope? You will be finding there, and some additional information are there. There's an appendix A and appendix B's are there. Okay, so this is again in 100 pages only. So your PTO guide is around 70 pages, and your admin guide is around approximately 100. The remaining part, the whatever the exercises we have seen here, right, in this admin guide, those solutions are given in the upcoming, after this, after till page number 389, the solutions are also given, okay, which I have already shown you, some of them are already in the system, and tomorrow we'll be seeing another 4 or 5 those lab exercises, okay. Then once tomorrow we'll be completing this part A of it, okay. Then is that fine? That's it.
That's okay.
But you have a lot of activities. You have to do a lot of study today. Okay. Otherwise, there will be no use. Once you study it,
give me access to the system, right?
I'll be sharing immediately after this session. I'll just immediately sharing with the access, and you have access to this my this GoToMeeting access. You just log in into that, and you download last yesterday's session. And for tomorrow's session, it will take another 1 and 1.5 hours to get it uploaded. Then you can download that also.
Okay.
Okay. Then that's all for today.
Sure.
Yeah. Bye. Good night.
Tomorrow, same time.
Same time. Yeah. Same time. I prefer the same time, 6 o'clock.
Same
link. If any URL, because this URL will be active for the next 7 to 8 days. Okay. Till that time, we'll be completing part B. Don't worry. And if any changes, I'll be telling you the new URL. Okay.
Sounds good. Okay. Thank you.
Yeah, sounds good. Bye. Thank you.